Well, let's get started on this. May not be a very long stream depending on how long the floor takes. Pretty big, but there's a lot of semi backtracking you have to do on it to get through it. Good that we can kill at least something on it. There is one enemy I'm kind of unsure if we'll be able to damage. It's these butterflies, I believe. Yeah. Kind of what I expected. That's not good. So even with the buffs, Kage can still get through, which is fantastic. What's that called? The butterfly? I think it's supposed to be like a flower. Made everyone back into a monk exploration a bit easier. Thought about just leaving them as the classes they had yesterday. Have to try to kind of expected that to happen. That attack has a pretty low attack modifier. I think it's like high, like damage multiplier instead. I kind of had a feeling that Yomu wouldn't be able to damage it with that particular attack. That mirror has a pretty nasty thing to use. Island force. I believe it halves your HP, and it's like a multi-target attack as well. It can really just burn through your TP if you let it get it all. The enemies are also very fast at this section. So that's another reason why I wanted to have everyone as monks. Except for this either cannon, this thing's actually... So it also has very high defenses. off a Yuko that actually. I also collected more Treasure Chest keys off stream. Of course, the one time I bring Yuko, we get the books. Oh, she actually damages them quite a lot, too. I was expecting that they would have a lot more mind than that. Yeah, that plant's like super fast. So probably should have switched to Kaguya with Finchi, their MV back. Kind of unfortunate that I didn't think to do that. Zemnis are pretty tanky, though that one is in particular for me. More regalia material is always nice. I don't know why I thought that was weak to wind for a second. Okay, so that one just sends us back. But we're definitely not damaging flower this time. As expected. Monk's really nice on Petchery in conjunction with that. With the BTB reduction on here. You get really high casting speed on sometimes because of it. They're just trusted royal flare. Iron even patch here, they can't damage the plants. Look at the flowers, rather. Back with Kaguya. Maybe Racing can. Might actually check. Unless you can pierce it, please. Better than nothing. I Eight quick. How's it going? Also, is my microphone still fine? I don't know if my OBS setting is different. My bar was like split over a bit from where it used to be. I just want to make sure it's still okay. Bit louder. I don't know if I can get any louder. Might just be where I'm sitting. Still one more thing I didn't get up there. The thing is, the game's already pretty low, like, it's actually really low on OBS. I have not. I never watched the trailers, honestly. I just wait till the stuff comes out. Okay, so there are actually two places to go. Oh yeah, it's just never something that's like on my mind, like a priority to get done. That's why I just never bother. He's a heal patch, really. Actually, healer. Oh, I did zero. Come on. That's unfortunate. I never used the English slime hats, so I couldn't tell you. I always just use the green root B on everyone. Then I just put the luck and pluck on whoever's killing the basement enemies. It's the main equip. It's this one. This one, this is the other one I use, the violin crew. I just put them on everyone except for the person who's killing stuff. Do you have your... Sorry about that. Do you have your main character as an appraiser when you kill stuff? Unless you're maxed out on everyone, is that what you meant? Yeah, for the gem thing. Like, are you maxed out on some gems that you don't want? Yeah, I can see what you mean by that. That'd be kind of interesting. And I can't wait till we can finish the basement so that I can get the boost for the corridor. And then we can just finally start getting more characters awakening. Let me just double check which this was. So it is. So it's that one there. To make sure I know how to get back here. How are we doing on materials now? I only one of these. Taking forever to get to 99. Hey, Rizash. Oh shoot, that's not gonna kill. Reserve Pagia and silence this thing. Maybe that attack is physical. That did an awful lot, even with silence. Yeah, the boost on the baseline is gonna be so good. Especially with the extra money and levels you get from it. We'll probably be close to like 700 on everyone. Then we can figure like all the way up until probably like 4150 at least. Gonna be a pain spending all of the money, though. I didn't even end up spending, like, the 56 million I had. I only did, like 30 million of it, because it just took too long to do it over the course. And damage. That enemy doesn't have like any defense, so that's why it did so much, but it's still kind of funny just to see Wriggle doing over 1 million damage. Alright, this crap. I think it's the one that goes down, is like the one that just takes you back. I'm not 100% confident in that, so we're just gonna have to check all of them. Oh shit. I'll think you lived. Well, it didn't go as bad as it could have. Something tells me it's the down one. But I think it's... Hey, this one just takes us back. In mind. It was not the one that goes down. But it didn't, like, send us too far back at least. That's probably like the best case scenario. There's one encounter we haven't ran into yet, surprisingly. It's like yellow butterflies we can find here. Kind of surprised we haven't seen them yet. Oh, I thought this was going to be another choose your own path thing. One though, fortunately. I think this one might be though. Just debuff it at least. So we can kill it. Oh nice, a blue crystal rod. I didn't actually know what those enemies even draw. I'm actually just gonna weaken this perpetually. Make sure she kills it. Breath sweep in just for the accuracy increase, so that you didn't miss. Wait, did we already find the end of it? Okay, it's really lucky. The enemies actually aren't like all resistant to spirit. I just want it monk because some of the enemies, like these parabola plants, I guess is how it's supposed to be said. They're like super fast, and so I wanted to try to make sure I could outspeed as many things as possible. Otherwise, that subclass would be better. Most things are weak to fire though, so Royal Flare is better, I'd say, on this one. Also, I love this shortcut because it's completely useless. Since there's no teleporter that takes you back from that area. I'll just explore this stuff while we have it available. It outsped me even with the increased ATB from using the normal attack. Alright, this is the annoying thing. You have to like repeatedly leave and enter all these tiles because of the way it's designed. No shock, unfortunately. That is a boss you are not even going to bother trying to fight at the moment. Possibly next level, or I just hit my controller. That might have been really loud on all guys. Possibly next stream, we might be able to fight that guy. We'll see. For this stream, we definitely aren't going to be able to check. Much as I want to, because you get a really nice reward. Million damage because of the final blow boost in the silence. Let's go uncover the area up here, I guess. And she's about to be kicked out anyway. That could have been really bad if he had use a different attack. Got our sentry down. Let's put the sweet up front so we have boosted accuracy. I can actually fight this boss though, definitely. I'm actually not sure how tough he'll be with our equipment. I'm not even gonna bother using those right now. I'll do it after. Once we finish going through the entire floor. Actually, I'm kinda curious to see what the other enemies are. Oh, interesting. It actually gives us all the spirits from the Hollow Orochi, even though we didn't kill them all. Okay, I didn't actually know that. This one gives the Falcon Sword and Real Claws. I don't actually know what the meld technique may be. Archero skin, interesting. <laughs> 0.3% chance. Possibly. That was a fun drop rate. I mean, they're okay. Like, the Archero's gems are decent. And I have like tons of these already, and blue crystal rods. And I get pretty much like all my enemies from those, and I have like three of galleries. The blue crystal rod's pretty good. Gives paralysis resistance, which is nice. Not amazing, but I mean, pretty decent. Like, it helps Kaguya get over the 100 benchmark here. Further back in the thing. Yeah, they're not as good as the Power Blades or the Crimson Lotus, but if you just run out of those and you need magic items, they're definitely good if you don't have like page 12 stuff. Alright, time to remember how to get back to where we were. It's gonna be quite a journey. Okay, I need to actually just have the map open here because I can't see the mini map with the stupid sunlight thing. It's like blinding it. I think it was the one that's down here. too far down. And then I believe it was that like plus sign shaped thing. This one over here, I think, is the right one to go into. Yep, okay, you made it back. Oh, apparently this takes us here as well. Or unless we already went in that, I didn't even know. Maybe I went in that one without realizing. So I was like, not paying attention. That's fine though, you can get back really quickly at least. And unfortunately, we have a bunch of branching paths again. I was hoping that wasn't going to kill so that I could switch Kaguya one more time. Alright, so now we have three paths to pick from. We'll just start with the right one. Oh no. Now there's two. It still does zero. But fortunately, Yuka is strong enough to kill it. Alright, I guess we'll just check down first. Down was a mistake. Oh well, it's fine. Not that bad having to walk back. Okay. That works. Dude, the Miko suffering, I know the feeling. That's what it's like when you use Patchouli and Kaguya. They're just behind everyone so much. I mean, Miko has really good stats at least. And Utsuho has Fighting Spirit. So, they're pretty good anyway. I wouldn't worry too much about that. Dang. Well, that really sucks because Kaguya just lost so much PP from that. Maybe not, she didn't look like she went down at all. Okay, please don't just loot me somewhere bad. You know, I should really check out Dragon Necklace kill those so I don't have to use all of my MP. That's not good. Okay. We didn't miss with the Kaguya at least. For a second, I forgot they were weak to Misty. Nice, now we're branching that. Okay. Well, looks like progress somewhere. Or at least progress, I should say. They already, like, got to the end, like, so yeah. Okay, nice, that actually kills them from full. So I don't have to worry about using all of my MP up. Ooh, that's really nice. Another Power Dragon Scale now. Lots of affinities. I'm gonna give that to Yomu, I think. She only loses. Also, wait. Oh, she has exactly 100,000 defense. You don't really see even numbers like that very often. Okay, we're actually way back here. I was kind of confused for a second where I was. I think the 30 floor enemies, the bosses that you can kill with the Kohos, I think they're better experience than the basement if you can kill them really quickly. Okay, so we've gotten all of those. We're actually almost done with the floor now, surprisingly. Oh, I remember this one taking a lot longer than my first time through it. It should just be that thing up the top there. A paste. Fortunately, it's not the 112. We already got a 113. Although I technically started the stream, I didn't actually start the game for like 3 minutes. So I guess technically we're still on pace for a 112. We have like a minute to finish the floor. Oh boy, another ribbon to add to my collection of like 25. What I always wanted. And we finished it. Amazing. Wait, did we? Okay, that was my player model that was making that orange. I was kind of confused for a second. Well, that's how you're supposed to do, like, the whole endurance. You just run through and play everything. There's many better quick at least. I wouldn't bother just killing one of them and leaving. That sounds really like inefficient. If you're like level 3000, you should be able to kill most of them really easily. Let's do that. Pretty sure the dragon's immune to poison. Well, I could land it with a race, I guess. Get rid of some people for a sec. Anyone else I'm going to want? Not susceptible to terror either, so... Yeah, poison might just be a waste to bother trying to land. I think I might just take Mist just so he can cycle in easier. Alright, so. We need a lot of HP and stuff. This guy hits pretty hard. I'm actually gonna buy another one of those. No, they go away after a number of turns pass. You get like one turn to hit her on physical, and then you get another turn to hit her on magical, magic attack. Yeah, you just have to wait it out until the defense one, the physical one will wear off first, and then the magic one will wear off after like another turn or two. Just a waiting game. You can try to poison her if you want, I'm pretty sure she's weak to it. Yeah, I'm gonna get my subclasses first. Don't forget to do that. Gonna bother with Yuka because she's not in the party. Let's do off the last. We'll get Guardian to Tenchi. Try to just keep an eye. I'm not gonna debuff myself with a Lord Master this time. I wanna make sure Castle has good survivability. The blue phase is weak to dark and That's where she's gonna be getting used. Who am I missing that's in the party? Mistia, okay. One off should be good. Gonna have her as a backup healer. I shouldn't have gotten all those. I don't know if I can afford them all. My yokai, we need this. Now we should be able to get everything that I want. We're gonna probably end up using spirit, but I'll get it anyways. She's not feeling, but whatever. I don't actually remember if leveling those up produces the DTD on them, but that's not it too anyway. Make sure Sulok was on. Okay. As well as get this in case we end up using it. When we went to Tokiko event, the only person I think we skipped is Minoriko. Out of like all the events. Come back to racing and stuff. I might give that to Akio instead. Or I could give her this instead. If we give her an extra turn to revive. That also works. Let's give her the Quartz Charm for the extra damage reduction. I need to put my laptop in. have a feeling Mistia isn't going to survive anyway, but might as well try to bank on evasion. Wait, we have the Force Booster, which is better than that. You need a lot of wind resistance. Can give it a shot. I'm gonna start with Minoriko just to get a damage reduction going. I think quite a bit. Red phase first. Oh jeez, that one's fast. I didn't expect him to catch me twice like that. I didn't even notice his ACB. Oh. There goes Yugi. Nice, I got invincibility on everyone. Okay. I think he does one more attack before the pattern resets. Nope, okay, it just resets. We can live that though. Omnitori, she has like plenty of resistance. Rare equipment. Phases. I'm gonna go with debuffs first. I'm gonna protect Grayson. He might get two shot by this. Oh yeah, she's gonna get destroyed. One phase. Right. Seems a tiny tad bullshit. It's something like that. Keep in mind, I'm like super over leveled too for this. Unfortunately, Mistia didn't avoid. He has a pretty good chance. Yeah, this guy's accuracy isn't that high. Alright, here we go. Empty's okay, don't worry. There we go. That was my goal, was just to get the red phase so that Suwako would shred it. So I'm just trying to like survive through the blue one with the debuffs, which worked out a bit. So here we have floor 29. I guess just for demonstration. Enemies are now higher level than I am, so we're going to listen to what the dragon told us and go somewhere else. Also, we got the Dragon God scale, which gives us a new subclass, Dragon God's Power. Boosts HP, MP, TP. It says all affinities, and when it says all affinities, it really means all affinities by like a huge amount. You get like plus 60 in every single affinity or something. Plus more increasing, why not? Yeah, I'll just reset Minoriko and you can see just how much it goes up. So he's got 77 fire resistance right now. She has 141. Now she has 201. Yeah. Just a bit of an increase. Anyway. Now we get to do some fun. Gotta reset some people that are in the party. That's probably good enough. This is the part where we indeed run from everything. We're gonna keep the Tokugawa statue. What am I looking for? Boost. Boost. 11,000 speed. Take this off. Go down to 8,000. Might actually be worth it, because if we take it off, we can run the that thing that Taki has. Gives us 79 TP. Do I have the That actually still works even if you run from the battle, so we're gonna get it. I don't know why it does, but it does. I'll use this Platinum Yandorian card, which I never use, but it's actually kind of useful in this situation. Actually, wait, I need to put Strategist on Tenshi, but it's on Sinai. I want to keep Sinai in the back. You just have to survive. Is what you're equipping her for. Chen is not a character with nature, so no Chen indeed. Jen doesn't have nature as an element, so she's not in the party. Even though I technically could use her for that reason. Oh, whoops, I didn't run away, what am I doing? Because we are the nature playthrough. And every character I use has to have nature. So that is why Chen is not being used. I don't know why you did not notice, but that is indeed the reason why we are not using Chen. Also more invisibility, but it's not much. Actually, there isn't too much invisibility in this one. Yes, Princess Tenko is nature. Alright, you can't check on this, but yeah. Nature in this game. Akyu is the one exception to the rule for this playthrough, because her nature spell is her awakening, which you obviously don't have from the start of the game, but I still used her way before I had her awakening. So she is the like one minor exception to the playthrough. But I have her awakening now, so it doesn't really matter. I just did it because it makes the game more fun having everyone than just waiting to beat Orochi. Physical playthrough one. Physical is probably like the best element to pick. You get the most characters with it. Like even if you're not, even if without the joking attack option thing, physical is actually like the one with the most characters. You get 25, I believe. Oh boy, Quartz Charm. Nature gets 19. And I like the characters on Nature, that's why I picked it. Are the physical characters good characters? Yeah. Well, most of them are. I think Spirit might be the easiest one to beat the game with. That one gives you the Grey Moon stuff. And a lot of bosses happen to be weak to Spirit. It's like a really good element in general. Alien in green. As long as you don't pick like fire or cold, I'd say you're pretty good. Fire and cold have the fewest characters, like 12 and 13, I think. Dark's really good, I think that also has 19. And you get like Aethyn in Vrunia, so that's pretty good. Bogasek, like Kassin. You get a lot of good characters with Dark. Ina, Arzi. So you have like the big terror thing going on with that one too. Landra as well. One of like the best characters. Is that the MP one or is that the MP one? Do I use the Will of Gensokyo? Not really. I'd usually just run Regalia, Quartz Charm, Potion of Life on everyone. Yeah, Komachi has like physical and spirit and cold. Now Tenchi's dead. If you've opened all the other rocks, then you should have all of them then. Can't exactly like tell you off the top of my head. Well, if you full cleared, you should get a good amount of experience. I think the levels is pretty good if you're already like 3,000. Also, you do get the Ancient Scepter from a chest. I didn't remember that one. Oh, crap. Yeah, that's quite the name. Yeah, I want to get that top one first. Oh, I just realized I never put a Notorious level up on this. I completely forgot to do that. You definitely wouldn't be getting outsped by anything. I don't actually remember if there is a teleporter that takes you back, so I'm going to go get this first, just in case. Would a void playthrough be possible? Probably, if you just went like crazy hard leveling. Like, I'm thinking, who do you get? You get like Maribel and Quaishi, and I think that's it. My mind doesn't stop you if you level enough. Okay, so I had a feeling there wasn't going to be a teleporter. Same, our. Let's get our bonus for coming here. Yeah, big XP and big money. Which I am not looking forward to spending that. Wow, suddenly we're similar level to the enemies that are on the floor above us. Crazy. Yeah, spending money, which I'm going to do on my own. And we just have more bosses and exploration. I might do the corridor for a bit first. Before we continue upwards in the tree. Get more awakening stones. Because now we're at the level where we pretty much can afford like all the skills on anyone. And there we go. Got the floor done. Yeah, there's a boss we might be able to beat next time, but I would definitely need to spend my money first before we even have to stand a chance against him. And it'll probably depend a lot on luck anyway, even if I tried at our level. So that'll be it for today. Thanks for watching.